Good morning, everybody. My name is Bente Klarlund Pedersen, and I am a member of the Executive Board of ECSS. And it's a very great pleasure for me to announce this exchange symposium between the Japanese Sports Society and ECSS. A special thank to Professor Nakatomi, who have been extremely loyal to ECSS during, I think, since the very first ECSS meeting. So the idea is to join forces and have talks from Japanese researchers and European researchers, in this case from Denmark. And I just want to express my gratitude to the Japanese colleagues for being loyal to the society and for teaming up. Actually, Japan has more members, paying members to this this symposium than any other country. This is fantastic. Close to 300 people from Japan is here. I think it's really fantastic, and we want to strengthen this relationship during the coming years. The floor is yours, Nakatomi. Unfortunately, I have to go to the executive board to plan the next meeting. Yeah.
So, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We are supposed to have close to 300 Japanese people, but I don't know. I have a blurred vision now. So, but still. I'm very much looking forward to have more people eventually. So first, I'd like to briefly, and before starting my session, I greatly, I would like to show my great appreciation to Bente and Tim, and also the organizers of this particular Metropolitan Rural Conference, and all the people in the ECSS board. And this is the 20th exchange symposium, as I would like to mention. And I'm very happy to be here and to be involved with all you guys, all the people here in Europe. And first, the brief introduction of our society. Our society is Japanese Society of Physical Fitness and Sports Medicine, and founded in 1949, which actually is older than ECSS. So we have quite a long history, and we have approximately 4,500 people, members. And I would like to stress this part, activities. We will have our annual meeting in September 16th to 18th, and we have an exchange symposium with ECSS. And here, the winners, the three winners of the ECSS Young Investigators Awards will be invited. So please run to me if you get the prize. And next slide, please. So I'd like to open this 20th exchange symposium, and the title will be The Challenging Physical Inactivity in Childhood and Adolescence, what cross-border evidence and issues do we have? And so I'd like to mention there are differences in many systems for physical inactivity combating for childhood. Please, next slide, please. Oh no, the next one, you're going back. Okay. So sport, first I'd like to briefly mention about the sports opportunities in Japan for children and adolescents. And this is basically a school-based model, which is quite different from the European style. And Korea, China, the East Asian countries, you know, have similar system. So the primary school kids, junior high school kids, senior high school kids, they all have physical education classes. This is obligatory, but for more organized sports or intensive sports, they will participate for organized sport activities, but at school. Here in Europe, like you have more Sportverein, for example, in Germany, and they are in non-school or out-of-school arts activities. But here in Japan, we in Japan have especially junior high school and senior high school, close to half or more than half of the kids are involved in sports, organized sports activities at school. And of course, like we had the non-school sports activities are growing, but still the number is based on, I mean, we are focusing on the at school activities. Next slide, please.
Oh yeah.
Yes. So 3 years ago, we have a new governmental agency, Japan Sports Agency. And among the list of policies, among top three, we have improving children's physical fitness and enhancing physical education, the sports club activities at school. So we are gonna stick to the at school models. Okay, next slide, please. So this is gonna be the last slide.
Oh no.
Pardon me. So I'm ordering myself. Okay, physical activity in childhood and adolescence. So what is the problem? Inactivity leading to obesity, cardiovascular disease risk factors, or underdeveloped motor functions, cognitive functions, which actually is also important for kids as well, and prone to sports injury, less passion to exercise sports and sports when they grow up in future. Where and when? School, home, commuting, sports clubs, and how? Physical education class programs, though they're more to high-risk approach. This model is more beneficial for high-risk kids with a great amount of physical inactivity. And as I mentioned, out-of-school hours organized sports opportunities. So here in Europe, maybe sports clubs or non-organized private associations may be possible, or interest groups. But here, in Japan, like school clubs will be the main focus. So for outcomes, we need more and more evidence for physical activity, fitness, participation, cardiovascular disease risk factors, injury, or academic achievement and brain function should also be very important, because sports is not for health, but sports is also for development of kids, or socialization. So now I'd like to invite the first speaker from Japan, Professor Koya Suzuki from Juntendo University. So we'll have 20 minutes talk from three speakers. And after that, I'll take a short, technical or confirmational questions, one or two after each session, and we hopefully we'll have like 10 minutes overall discussion.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for Professor Nagatomi. I'm really honored to be here on this special occasion in the huge, huge room. I appreciate the Japanese Society of Physical Fitness and Sports Medicine and ECSS Organizing Committee give me an opportunity to talk about our research project. My name is Koya Suzuki. I'm from Juntendo University. Have you ever heard Juntendo? No? Have you ever heard Nintendo company, right? Actually, Juntendo and Nintendo pronunciation really similar, but a big difference. Nintendo company make unhealthy sedentary children, but Juntendo University develop energetic, active, healthy children, right? Don't forget the Juntendo name, right? Actually, today, so my presentation is a cross-cultural comparison of physical activity and fitness in Asian adolescents. My presentation data is almost AJFIT study data. So I'll introduce firstly the AJFIT study. Declining physical fitness and physical activity and low physical fitness level are important predictors for some chronic disease, including obesity and cardiovascular disease, there are some strong results showed lack of physical activity. Some studies suggested that culture, educational system, and the economic and social context may influence children's physical activity and the physical fitness and the weight status. Comparing these factors, each country is very important for physical activity promotion and obesity prevention. Each city. In 2012, our study group was launched Asia Fit study in order to compare level of physical activity, physical fitness, and obesity among major metropolitan cities in East and Southeast Asia. Our study group consists of 8 Asian major cities: Singapore, China, Shanghai, China, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, Seoul, South Korea, Taipei, and Bangkok, Thailand, Hong Kong, and Tokyo, Japan. We intended to keep area balancing from north to south for city selection. Of course, sports science to be able to perform the study is also an important requirement to extract the cities. By the way, what's new in our study? Some researchers have reported geographic variability and the secular trends of physical fitness in children and adolescents. Some of the representative researchers are Grant Tomkinson from University of North Dakota, USA, and Timothy Oles from University of South Australia. Actually, he was advisor of Tomkinson, who were a PhD student at the at his laboratory before. They have published an article to show international trends and ranking relating to physical fitness. But these kinds of cross-cultural research is mainly focused on aerobic fitness and country ranking as an analysis viewpoint. Because endurance test is standardized through the world as a health-related fitness, most of the study also analyzes it using national statistical data, which is published by public institution each country. Therefore, these studies are not able to analyze the cause of the high or low fit, which based on the examination of factor variables. In addition to this problem, national statistical data is combined with urban-rural effect each country. So within country effect and between country effect cannot be divided in these studies. So our Asian fit study is able to resolve the problem by means of the same test battery, same questionnaire, and sampling metropolitan cities. In this presentation, I will show the simple comparison data at first. Then I will show the result of a causal analysis each metropolitan city. We investigated many kinds of factors as a questionnaire: lifestyle habit, sleeping habits, eating habit, of course, physical activity and sedentary behavior, and educational system, and so on. But today, especially, I'm going to focus on the organized sports club activity. A total of 12,590 valid adolescents were collected from 8 major metropolitan cities. Approximately 1,600 secondary school students aged 12 to 15 years old were recruited from each city using stratified random sampling procedure according to their specific geographic distribution in each city. We chose the test battery based on the health data, physical fitness, and the test characteristics, that is validity, reliability, simplicity, and the feasibility of the test. We emphasize simplicity and feasibility. Actually, many testers engage edge-fit study. Project leader Professor Hoy held a workshop for tester development each city. So we did our best to maintain quality of the data. And the feasibility means low cost, small space for test, easy to administer with the test conducted the test. We finally choose 4 tests, fitness test, hand grip test for muscular strength, and sit and lay test for flexibility, 1 minute sit up for muscular endurance, and the short run test for cardiovascular fitness. I will show you some results of the AgiFit study. This figure shows average of hand grip strength each gender, each city. Shanghai adolescents were highest in the 8 cities. And Kuala Lumpur boys and Singapore girls were lowest. Please remember, top city is Shanghai. Sit and reach test. In this test, students stretched forward with palm overlapping each hand, as this picture shows. And the tester recalled the forward movement distance of the fingertips upon reaching forward as far as possible. And flexibility of sole, as sole adolescents was highest level in 8 cities, and the Taipei boys and Bangkok girls were lowest. Remember, top city is Seoul. 1 minute sit-ups. Students rise up the upper body until the elbow touch sides, and the ankle until the mid-back touches the mat. 1 minute sit-ups was highest in Tokyo, adolescents, and the Kuala Lumpur boys and girls were lowest. Fifty-meter shuttle run test, option name Pacer, which is 50-meter version, not 20-meter version, because gym environment of metropolitan in Asia is generally a small space, a kind of basketball court, the width of 50-meter only, like this picture shows. A record of 50-meter, but the a record of 50-meter pacer can be converted into 20-meter version for estimating VO2 max. Pacer result was similar to a ranking of 1 minute sit-ups. Tokyo was top among cities, and the Bangkok boys and Kuala Lumpur girls were the worst rank. By the way, did you feel Japanese data was extremely high? Look at this. Actually, Japanese average boys and average is almost twice number of shuttles than the other cities. Did you doubt mistake of counting a repetition or the mistake of sound speed of pacer or sampling bias, subject were athletes, what do you think? Actually, project leader, Professor Hui, firstly doubt and sent the email to me, dear Koya and Sasha, just had a few minutes of Skype discussion with Koya about the extraordinary high result in the pacer test in Japanese students, blah, blah. All researchers know that the extraordinary high pacer test results in Japanese students. We have to seriously find out the reason why. Is it possible that to find another 10 students to redo the pacer test again using the same old music again as ASAP? I hope that you can record the whole process from the beginning until the end. Unbelievable thing as a collaborator. Actually, we had a confidence of quality of the data. But fundamentally, I'm a serious mind. So actually, I did the test again for record the whole process and the sending to him. Actually, in conclusion, I won. But I compared with the normative health fitness zone based on Buyo to Max, which is reported by Cooper Institute Fitness Gram. From the result, only in Japanese average met the standard. Blue area is a health fitness zone for boy, red area health fitness zone for girls. So I find the Japanese is not too high. The other city were too low and endurance level. Former information, according to article showed while ranking, Japanese ranks high class among the world, Tanzania, Estonia, Iceland, Japan, Norway, Denmark, and so on. Meanwhile, China and Hong Kong and rank lower class. So I feel sure that Japanese data is not a mistake. For summarizing fitness ranking, I show the top city and worst city, each test. In summary, East Asian adolescents tend to be higher fitness level than Southeast Asian adolescents. As you saw the previous slide, all of first ranking of fitness tests were East Asian city, Shanghai, Seoul, Tokyo. Let's move on to the next topic, organized sports activity. This data showed rate of participation in organized sports club each country. Prevalence of belonging to sports club in Tokyo were the highest, 50% for boys, 37% for girls. The worst city was Taipei, only 5% for boys, 4% for girls. Actually, as the Japanese participants know, in Japan, there are many types of club activity at school, sports club and culture club at school. I think key point is at school. Almost Japanese students play sports at school without paying money, no money. So all middle school provide free club activity at school after class as an educational aspect. So I consider that's why rate of participation in Tokyo is the highest. Similar system in Hong Kong and Singapore. So I think Hong Kong and Singapore also are higher. This figure showed the relationship between belonging organized sports club activity and pacer test score. Of course, the endurance of those who belonging to sports club was higher than non-sports club group. But however, there is a country difference of the effect size. Effect size of Tokyo was higher than the other cities. Interestingly, Bangkok Shanghai and Taipei prevalence of the the belonging to sports club group did not affect the pace score positively, so low effect size because of low effect size. So in Tokyo, organized sports activity is one of the important factor to develop endurance fitness. On the other hand, lower effect size in Bangkok, Shanghai, and Taipei means there are no relations between organized sports club activity and the fitness level. However, we may need to examine the characteristics of those who are belonging to the club. For instance, how often, how hard do they sports? In other words, intensity or frequency of the activity as the next analysis step. Next, I'd like to introduce sedentary behavior and physical activity data measured by questionnaire, IPAQ. First, I will show sedentary behavior data. Pool data and data each gender also show the Kuala Lumpur adolescents were the shortest sedentary behavior level. In East and Southeast Asia. Tokyo is also short. On the other hand, Seoul and Taipei adolescents spend longer time in sitting. However, result of two-way ANOVA, including city factor and gender factor, show the significant interaction. This means areal difference of sitting time difference between boys and girls. As you can see, the especially gender gap of Singapore adolescents is big. This graph showed average of moderate to vigorous physical activity in a week, each city, each gender. Tokyo boys and girls spend the longest time physically active, but Kuala Lumpur children was not high MVPA level. This is interesting phenomenon because, as I showed previous slide, Kuala Lumpur was the shortest sedentary behavior level. Additionally, we want to focus on the distribution of MVPA level as well as the average. Middle and high class decrease with decreasing ranking of the MVPA average. In the four worst cities, middle class shift to the left compared to the first rank, for instance, Japan. Anyway, the distribution is also differ according to cities. This table shows the ranking of MVPA level and the sedentary behavior. As you can see, physically active adolescents are not necessarily less sedentary behavior. In Tokyo, Bangkok, Hong Kong, physical activity and sedentary behavior level matched, but the other city do not match it.
Physically, up. All right.
We also investigated the magnitude of association between physical activity and the cardiovascular endurance. X-axis is standard regression coefficients. Y-axis is MVPA average per day in each city. As you can see, the magnitude of coefficients differ according to city, including previous slide. These data might indicate approach for physical activity promotion is different between city, and also the promotion effect is also different. This is the last slide. Our data indicated that East Asian physically fit, most of Japanese adolescents belong to sports club at school. Then relationship between sports club participation and physical fitness differ between cities. Relationship between sedentary behavior and the physical activity also differs between cities. Anyway, their social environment affects on difference of physical fitness and the relations between them and Asian adolescents. So even if subjects are from same Asian country, those response relations are different. So when we make a plan for health promotion, we require consideration of these kind of evidence. I appreciate all cooperation and the staff each city. Thank you for your attention.
Okay, one short question, if there's any, okay, please.
Thank you for the good presentation. I'm from Singapore, mm-hmm. from the same university, yeah. In fact, from the same school.
Do you know the Bara?
In fact, from the same department. That guy is my department head.
Ah, really?
Yeah, so the session started with the chair giving a prologue that it's more about physical inactivity or sedentariness. And then you moved on to physical fitness. So my question to you is, in order to curb obesity, what do you think? Physical activity is more important or achieving certain norms of physical fitness is more important?
I have no idea to the
same here.
Question. But yeah, I think it's the same. But physical fitness indicator is strong indicator to show the lifestyle habits compared to physical activity.
Interestingly,
so that's why I was focusing on.
Why I'm asking you this question is, mm-hmm. Singapore started physical fitness oriented school programs in 1999. Mm-hmm. After a decade, everything fell flat on the face. It was an absolute failure. So then we moved on to more holistic approach to health, which involved activity, diet, sleep, homework, everything packaged in a perfect manner. So we are still on with that. So in our socio-cultural context, physical fitness-based philosophy, driving physical activity promotion has not really worked. Mm-hmm. So I'm wondering, what's the rationale that you guys are embarking on meeting the norms of certain physical fitness criteria in an effort to combat childhood obesity or sedentariness for that matter. Mm.
In addition to that.
I'm just thinking, you know, what is driving you? What's your rationale on that?
Okay. This is an important question that we can cover in the overall discussion. Would you agree?
Yeah, sure. I mean,
okay.
It's a question.
Yeah.
And
I'm sure, like, you know, well, we only show the Japanese, like, educational system for physical activity promotion. But,
right.
Of course, like, diet, it's a holistic approach. It's very important, for example, to prevent obesity in childhood.
Right. And maybe just a suggestion. From Singapore, you use the questionnaire-based data. I have done a study using accelerometry. So we have more objectively validated evidence on the physical activity and sedentary behavior of Singaporean children. So maybe that'll help you get some more insights as regards your data is concerned. Mm-hmm. So you might want to look at that. It was published in the Journal of Physical Activity and Health in 2015. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate that good question. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.